The only reason y'all motherfuckers think that it is so much work to be natural is because you all let these natural hair beauty YouTube guru bullshits, whatever fuck it is, teach y'all and tell y'all, coerce y'all and scam y'all into thinking that y'all need shit that you don't need. Like, I really cannot. What really, really irks me is the people, like, is the fact that these YouTubers are literally out here scamming their own people for a check. Y'all really out here scamming y'all own people for a check. For a check. I let call. Go do something. Get a job. Don't scam people. What up, everybody? I am Lee Malzell, and this is my channel, and my hair looks a mess. I just look a mess all around, so please, please excuse my messiness today, but today we're gonna have to do a little rant, okay? I just came from work, and while I was at work today, I was watching some natural hair videos, some, you know, just supporting my fellow black YouTubers, you know? You gotta support the black woman, you gotta support the community. I need to speak up about this. This has been a video that I've been wanting to do for so fucking long. I've actually recorded this video so many times, and today is the motherfucking day. This video is for all of you natural beauty gurus. This video is for you people who are product junkies. This video is for you people who have just became natural and don't know what to do with your hair, okay? I'ma tell you this right now. I'ma start with you, okay? For the people who just been natural and don't know what to do with your hair, this is all you need to be natural, okay? I'ma tell y'all a secret, because clearly these motherfuckers are lying to you. You do not need no curl souffle. You don't need no damn pre-poo. You don't need no diffuser. You don't need no gel. You don't need no edge control. You don't need nothing but a wide tooth comb, water, and a spray bottle, an oil of your choice. It's gonna take some time to find what oil goes really well with your hair, but an oil of your choice, shampoo, conditioner, and if you want, some moisturizer. I recommend a moisturizer because it will make life easier, but there's a lot of things that God has given us, okay? The universe has blessed us with numerous things from the earth that we can use in our hair instead of going to support these big corporations and these supposed black-owned businesses, okay? And I say black-owned businesses because I'm gonna get to that later. There's a lot of things that we can use in our hair that we have right in our fucking kitchen that would do our hair so much more good than to sit there and support these motherfucking corporations that's only trying to sit there and exploit us, okay? The reason that this video topic really came to mind is because I am fucking sick and tired of people coming up to me asking me about my natural hair and then saying blatantly ignorant shit.
I would love to be natural, but you know, it's just way too much work to be natural, you know? And I don't think my hair would look like that.
I swear to God, if I had a dollar for every single time someone said that stupid shit to me, I would be so fucking rich. That doesn't even make any damn sense, okay? Now let me break it down to you as to how it don't make any sense, and then we're going to get into the title of this video, all right? How these natural hair beauty gurus are fucking scammers. Number one. Unless you literally just permed your hair, which I know a lot of black women in particular permed their hair when they were younger, you don't even know what the fuck your hair looks like. You don't know, because you haven't seen it. You don't know if you is a damn 3A, a 4B, or a 4C. You don't know what your hair type is. So how the hell could you say that you cannot manage your natural hair when you don't know what the fuck it looks like? I'll wait. Two, if you have been natural lately and you claim that you failed, just admit that you didn't know how to take care of your hair. I don't understand why people just be like,
oh, natural hair is just so hard to manage. Oh my God, like my natural hair just does so much. Like I just can't deal with it. You know, I feel like it's just so much easier to wear weaves and, you know, just to get a relaxer.
I just fucking can't. That three, the only reason y'all motherfuckers think that it is so much work to be natural is because y'all let these natural hair beauty YouTube guru bullshits, whatever fuck it is, teach y'all and tell y'all, coerce y'all and scam y'all into thinking that y'all need shit that you don't need. Like, I really cannot. These people sit here and they promote all of these things that you really do not need for your hair. 99% of the things that these people are promoting to you either cost too much damn money, or you could easily get the same effect with something you have in your damn house. Whether it be with olive oil, coconut oil, castor oil, shea butter, whatever the hell it is. You do not need all of these products.
Oh, but you know, I'm supporting black business.
No, kill that noise. That's absolute bullshit. And I'm gonna tell y'all why it's bullshit. Now, this goes for weaves. This goes for products. This goes for every single thing across the board that you think is black business, okay? First of all, unless this black business, okay? And I'm gonna start with the weave, okay? Unless this black business is out there and they are out in Cambodia, they're out in India, they're out in Brazil cutting the hair off of these donors' heads and they are wefting it together to sell it to you in a bundle, there is absolutely no way you're going to tell me that you're supporting black business, because at the end of the day, all of these black businesses, white businesses, green businesses, whatever the case may be, get they shit from China, okay? All that shit made in China, bitch. All that shit is in Taiwan, bitch. All that shit is in Hong Kong, bitch. That shit is not here. Yes, of course you're still helping the black person get their money. But at the same time, 9 times out of 10, the hair that you're buying from them and you're paying more for because they're a black business is the same shit you're gonna get from the beauty supply, from the white people that's scamming you. And I just don't get it. Like, y'all really think that these black people be out here wefting that shit together? Like, do y'all really think that y'all know all that shit made in China? Bitch, you better off going to AliExpress and just ordering it directly from there. Y'all be like, oh, AliExpress hair ain't good. Well, that's where y'all little black business YouTubers get that shit from. Fuck out of here. Oh, yeah. Don't get me started with the black hair products, okay?
I'm gonna buy this curl smoothie from this company in Wisconsin because, you know, they're black owned and it's a black business.
Okay, my thing is, unless this black business is out here cooking this shit up in their kitchen, there's absolutely no reason you're about to tell me that this shit is black business. I don't give a fuck. If you get your shit imported, okay? You get your shit imported, you're still helping the mass market. I don't care what nobody says. You still, no. That don't even make no sense. These motherfuckers ain't no damn Madam CJ Walker. They not out here cooking that shit up in the kitchen. Like, that don't even make any sense. Like, I don't understand. 90% of these things are imported, okay? I've worked for PR firms. I've worked for media firms. I work for e-commerce sites that sell a lot of this shit that y'all be buying. And honestly, 9 times out of 10, it's a scam. The shit that they put on their labels are scams. The shit that they promote to y'all as natural. Have y'all ever really sit there and look at the back of the product? That shit ain't natural. You can't pronounce 90% of the things on the back of the label. Natural wear. Natural wear. Natural who? What? Bitch. Bitch. Find it because I can't see it. The most natural thing on half of these labels is water. Okay? And then the things that are actually natural, they cost an arm and a leg. These shits be like $25 for a shampoo. For what? For what? Because I have natural hair, I gotta suffer? Bitch, fuck out of here, no. This is the thing, right? A lot of the industry mainstream shit that the Moon Blanc put in their hair, okay, the Diri Blanc, the white people, the shit that the white people put in their hair, I could put in my hair and it could do the same shit, and Shea Moisture will do the same shit as all this other expensive ass shit that y'all trying to coerce me into buying. I'm not dumb. My issue is not with corporations and people making their money. I get it, be an entrepreneur, get your shit. My problem is with people who sit there and buy loads and loads of products they don't fucking need. okay? And they're being scammed by these ancient ass natural hair beauty gurus, okay? This goes for makeup, this goes for hair, this goes for a whole bunch of shit. They're making you buy all of this shit that you don't need, okay? You do not need no damn curl pudding, you don't need no curl souffle, you don't need no pre-poo, you don't need no diffuser, you don't, this, bruh. You do not need a scalp brush, you got your damn fingers. You do not need a curl pudding. Use some damn aloe vera juice. Use some coconut oil and use some water. You do not need no damn edge control. Use some shea butter and use some water. Grab a brush and slick those shits the fuck down. Stop putting money in these motherfuckers' pockets. Stop putting money in these motherfuckers' pockets. Like, I cannot. What really, really irks me is the people, like, is the fact that these YouTubers are literally out here scamming their own people for a check. Y'all really out here scamming y'all own people for a check. For a check. I let call. Go do something. Get a job. Don't scam people. Yeah, you could be a YouTuber. You could share your knowledge. There's nothing wrong with sharing knowledge. But when you sit there, you come up on camera with like a $30, $40 fucking product that you know your subscribers cannot fucking afford, but you know they're going to buy it because it's you promoting it and you ain't never used that shit a day in your life, and you sitting up on camera talking about some, oh, this is the best thing I ever used in my life.
This is my first reaction of this product, but it's the greatest thing ever.
But you won't ever see that motherfucking product ever again. These hoes be literally selling themselves out. How the hell do you have a product that you love so much, okay? How do you like this product so much and you just unbox it?
Even though I'm being paid to do this video, I'm gonna give you guys my honest opinion. Oh, it makes my hair long. My hair is growing 5 inches since I started using it.
Bitch, when you started using it 5 minutes ago? Cause you just said that it's your first time opening the thing. Oh yeah, it's amazing. They be trying to lie to y'all. They be sitting there like, oh yeah, I've used this before and this is like my second box. I'm not dumb. I'm not dumb. This is not your second box. This is your first box. You a liar. You a liar. Oh, man. I cannot. These motherfucking YouTubers get on my motherfucking nerve. I've been natural for about 3 years now, okay? And I've just heard so much ignorant shit about natural hair. And I just feel like everyone should be natural. I'm one of those. That's why, like, lately I've been trying to stay away from even, like, straight hairstyles. Even when I do a weave, I'll do braids. I'll do, like, natural looking type of shit, like, legit, like, kinky, curly type of stuff, because I like my hair. I like my hair pattern. I like to keep my shit the way it is. I like to keep my shit true to self. So I don't do the whole weaving and all of that, like that, unless it's, like, for a special occasion. Last time I had a weave, it was for my friend's wedding. The time before that, it was for graduation. Other than that, I don't really do that. And if I do, I'll probably keep it in my head for, like, a week or two, because I want a different style. There's nothing wrong with wearing weave, and there's nothing wrong with experimenting with your hair. But when you sit there and you're coming up on camera and you're basically lying to your subscribers and telling them that something's good when you really don't know, or you know that it's not, just because you're getting cut a check and you want somebody to boost up your affiliate codes and your quota for the month for a company, that's fucking wrong, okay? When you're sitting there and you're guilting your subscribers into buying shit that you know damn well is not good, that is not okay. When you're sitting there and you are saying that you're supporting black business, but you know damn well you're really supporting the damn scammers in China or whatever, that is not okay. This is the main reason I refuse to buy anything, okay? The only thing that you need to take care of your natural hair is a wide tooth comb, a spray bottle with water, a good shampoo, a good conditioner, and a moisturizer, and the oil of choice, okay? And you need to stick to all of those things. This is why people always ask me, like, oh my God, how'd you grow your hair? Oh my God, your hair's so healthy. You know why? Because I stick to the same products. You cannot sit there and put all of these thousands, these hundreds and thousands of different shit in your hair and expect your hair to grow. You have to stick to one thing so that your scalp and your hair can get used to whatever it is that you're putting in your hair. You cannot just every day you putting a new curl smoothie, every day use another shampoo, every day you're doing this, that, and the third. No, that's why you get a regimen and you stick to that regimen. Now, where in the world does it make sense for these natural beauty gurus to be using tens and thousands of different shits in their hair, and they marketing it all to you saying that that's what grew their hair and that's what made their hair do this and that. Does that make any sense? You think that these beauty gurus with their hair all the way down to their butt is literally using all of these products that they're marketing to you all the time and that's what grew their hair? No. They either A, are not telling you exactly what they use in their hair, or B, y'all just really dumb. Because there's no way that a YouTuber is really sitting there and they're like, oh,
this is what I use. I use this in my hair every day. I use this in my hair every day. I use this in my hair every week. I use this in my hair every month.
And all of a sudden, every month they have a new couple of things that they use. So realistically, I've seen YouTubers literally promote at least 2 products a month. So 2 times 12, that's 24. So you're telling me these motherfuckers are using 24 products. 24 products a year on their hair to get their hair to waist length? No. Like, come on, guys. Let's be real here. These motherfuckers will introduce a new product and you will never see the product again, but somehow it magically made their hair grow. Let me know. These fucking YouTubers is some fucking scammers and that shit is so annoying. What really annoys me for real is the fact that these YouTubers will sit there and they will bash the true natural hair gurus. Like, they'll sit there and they'll be like, oh, these are the trends that we have to ditch in 2018. You know, all of this crazy stuff that you guys are doing, oh, putting mayonnaise in your hair, oh, putting eggs in your hair. You need to stop doing that because that's not doing anything. Bitch, shut your ass the fuck up. You only saying that so I could buy your stupid ass curl souffle that you fucking promoting. That's like $50. You want me to go buy that with your coupon code so you can get some money? I ain't dumb. They promoting a product every 2 seconds. They promoting an affiliate code every 2 seconds. They are sitting there and they are lies, okay? They lie to you. Money, that's it. A lot of the times, the things that you are buying from these companies who claim that they're making things for natural hair are people who are just trying to make money and profit off of and exploit the black community. And then you got these black YouTubers sitting here and endorsing that fucking bullshit, and I can't. They'll promote this shit just for a check, promoting this shit just to get money, exploiting their brothers and sisters for some money, telling you that a product is good for some money, telling you your hair is gonna grow even though they ain't never used that product a day in their life, just for some money. And I'm hip to the motherfucking game because I've worked in places like that. I'm not stupid. A lot of these times they literally take the same product that they have, all they do is put a different label on it. It's the same shit. They'll probably flip a few little ingredients in there. They'll probably be like, yeah, infused with argan oil. Boy, that shit like 2% argan oil, 90% of it is water, and then 10% of it is a whole bunch of harmful shit you shouldn't even be putting in your hair. My thing is, if you cannot pronounce 90% of the things on the back of the bottle is not natural, that shit doesn't make any sense. That's not logical. I think I got everything off my chest. Let me know what y'all think. Some of y'all about to comment on here and be mad as hell, but I don't give a shit. Y'all need to hear the fucking truth. Stop supporting these fucking scammers. Stop sitting here and buying all of this unnecessary shit. Take good care of your hair. Do actual research. Research what hair type you have. Research the porosity level of your hair. Research. And by research, I mean actually Google the shit. Don't be sitting here watching these scamming ass YouTubers, because that's all they want is your fucking money. They don't care about you. They do not have your best interest at heart, okay? Actually research, do your homework, and go from there. Trial and error. See what works for your hair and what does not, and your hair will grow. Stop all that foolishness. Stop putting all that extra shit in your hair. When you sit in there, you're putting numerous products in your hair on a regular basis. That's not helping you. Stick to a few products, use it, call it a day. Stick to your water, stick to your oil, to maybe one moisturizer, and you'll be good. I'm done ranting. I think I'm done ranting, okay? Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. Follow me on social media, and I'ma see y'all next time.